Jose Benavidez just did an interview with Bernardo Osuna, one of the better people in ESPN to cover boxing. Bernardo does a hell of a job in English and Spanish. Mostly the Spanish side of ESPN kicks ass in boxing. The English side still has a long way to go. I don't think they have a grip on it yet, but maybe they will one day. Back to Jose Benavidez. Jose gave Crawford all the props after the fight. He said, Crawford's one of the best. I gave him a tougher fight than he expected. And he's right. He's right about that. No one expected Benavidez to go almost 12 rounds, 11 and a half rounds with Crawford. Benavidez also said that in the ninth round, his leg, the one he got shot 9 times in the leg. His leg that was shot just 2 years ago was giving out on him. And he never had it happen that bad, but he couldn't think about it. But he didn't want to give excuses or take away from the win of Crawford. He gave Crawford his props. I think the beef is squashed, which is great to see. You don't want people beefing like Khabib and Conor after their fights. You want people to move along and go back to their daily routine and not let it spill the bigger beefs or race wars and so on. Benavidez also said he's going to go back to the gym, train harder, work harder. Obviously, he's a well-deserved rest. In boxing, when you get stopped, he got stopped in the 12th round. 6 months, automatically, he can't fight again. So he's going to take some time off and then get back in the gym. That's why I'm so surprised that Derek Lewis, the UFC heavyweight that almost got stopped twice and won, is back in a cage in less than a month. I just don't get that. How'd they do that? And fighting for a championship, nonetheless. If you want DC to win a title, just give him the belt. Why are you having him fight a guy that has no chance of winning? Zero chances. But let's see what's next for Benavidez. He earned a lot of stripes tonight. A lot of people were impressed with him. I'm sure he's disappointed in his performance. Crawford gave his fans, his 13,000 fans at home, he's one of the most... he draws many, many fans. Mikey Garcia drew, I think, 14,000 at Staples Center. Errol Spence, 13,000 at Dallas Cowboys Stadium. Crawford, 13,000 today. So boxing is alive and well in the U.S., and there are guys at home that do draw. So that's a great thing. So we'll see what happens next. I'm interested to see who Crawford... I have a feeling, if you ask me who Terrence Crawford's fighting next, I think he's going to fight Egas Kavalauskas. Egas Kavalauskas, mean machine next. He's with Top Rank. He's undefeated. He is, I think, if I'm not mistaken, his record is 19-0 with 16 knockouts. So 20-0 with 16 knockouts. So there you have it. Stay tuned. For ESNEWSReporting.com. I'm Lasik back reporting. Take a step back, cause it's LA setback. Reporting. The wave of the future. We don't lose. Tell me what you're watching. ES News.